Hey y'all, welcome to the Fish Crew YouTube channel. Today we're going to talk about biological filtration as it relates to the aquarium hobby. Not only are we going to talk about what biological filtration is, but also what beneficial bacteria is, how to support its growth, and what biological filtration medias are most effective in your aquarium. So, let's begin. Biological filtration are types of filter media meant to hold beneficial bacteria colonies on their surface area and break down dissolved organic matter and convert it to a safer form. Beneficial bacteria consists of aerobic and anaerobic bacteria. Aerobic bacteria, or nitrifying bacteria, convert ammonia and nitrite into the safer form, nitrate. Anaerobic bacteria, or denitrifying bacteria, convert nitrate into nitrogen gas, which dissipates out of the aquarium. Ideally, fish tanks should have a combination of aerobic and anaerobic bacteria. But for this video, let's focus on aerobic bacteria, or nitrifying bacteria. In order to have a successful biofilter in our aquarium, we need to think of our bacteria like our fish, a living organism that requires certain living conditions in order to thrive. Beneficial bacteria, nitrifying bacteria specifically, require four basic things to survive: a pH above 6.0, ideally a pH above 6.5 in order for it to be most effective, temperatures above 55 degrees Fahrenheit, a food source, which in this case would be our ammonia or nitrite produced as our fish waste, and oxygen, which is why we need to have good water flow to our biological filtration in order to continuously replenish those oxygen levels to our bacteria. Beneficial bacteria growth is vital to a healthy aquarium because it breaks down the toxic fish waste before it has a chance to negatively impact the fish's organs. Now that we have discussed beneficial bacteria and its importance in our aquarium, let's go over the different types of biofilter medias and which ones are most effective in keeping a stable, healthy, low-maintenance tank. Ceramic rings are one of the most popular biofilter medias in the aquarium hobby today. They are composed of short, hollow tubes of unglazed ceramic, making them strong and unlikely to break down. Ceramic rings do not get clogged easily as they are not the most porous media, but their lack of porosity does not allow for as much bacterial growth as other products out there. BioBalls were one of the first biofilter medias on the market and were once the go-to for biological filtration. They are small, ridged, plastic balls that provide surface area for nitrifying bacteria. BioBalls are used less and less in the aquarium hobby today due to their high maintenance and their low surface area for bacterial growth. BioBalls catch detritus and other organic matter easily, so they need to be rinsed regularly in order to avoid nitrogen pockets. BioBalls are also made of plastic, meaning they are not very porous and don't have the best potential for biological filtration. Biosponges are another commonly used biological filter media, especially if the aquatic creatures you're trying to keep need very low flow in the tank. These sponges are usually thick, sturdy, large mesh sponges in which air is pushed through to create a void to encourage water movement through the sponge. Remember, beneficial bacteria need water flow to get oxygen. Also called bacterial sponge filters, these filters are great for beneficial bacteria growth. However, they can become clogged and need to be rinsed regularly, which can lead to some loss of beneficial bacteria growth on the sponge. A less commonly used biological filter media in the aquarium hobby is chalcedonous biological media. Chalcedonous biomedia are small plastic rings shaped like a circular window. They are made out of thin plastic and are better used for extremely large tanks or industrial applications. Porous biological filter media is rapidly becoming a more popular biological filter media and comes in many different shapes and sizes, from large bricks, to gems, to even star shapes. Generally very porous and great for aerobic as well as anaerobic bacteria growth. However, most porous biological filter media have too large of pores, causing not only excessive detritus buildup, but also making them very fragile and prone to falling apart. Most porous biofilter medias will not last the life of the tank because either they fall apart or the larger pores become clogged with detritus and can't be rinsed easily due to the fragility of the product. which leads us to our final biomedia we will be discussing today, matrix. Matrix is unlike other porous biofilter medias because of its strength and the size of its pores. Matrix is a one-shape-fits-all biomedia with pores small enough not to catch organic particulates or detritus, but large enough to allow bacteria growth both on its surface and at its center, where anaerobic bacteria thrive. Matrix can easily be rinsed in old tank water without compromising the integrity of its pores and the bacteria living within them, making it easy to maintain if necessary. Because of its strength, matrix should never have to be replaced in your filter like other biofilter medias that tend to break down over time. Because of these benefits, we recommend using matrix in all of your aquariums for your biological filtration. Keep in mind, bacteria grows on all surfaces in your tank. Your filter sponges, your substrate, rocks and decorations. We recommend that you consider this secondary bacteria because these surfaces are not stable enough for consistent bacterial colonies. What I mean by this is that when you siphon your gravel, take your decorations out of the tank to clean them, rinse your filter sponge to unclog it, all things we do for regular tank maintenance, you lose some of that secondary bacteria. This is why it is important to have as much surface area in your filter for beneficial bacteria growth as possible. Now that you know a little bit more about beneficial bacteria and the importance of biological filtration in your aquarium, you might agree with us. Matrix is the most beneficial biological filtration method out there because it is low maintenance, allows for aerobic as well as anaerobic bacteria growth, and is strong and lasts the lifetime of your aquarium. Hopefully, you feel a little bit more confident in your knowledge of biological filtration and what biofilter medias are most appropriate for your aquarium. Thanks for joining us. Please subscribe below and keep a lookout for more videos from your Northern Colorado aquarium experts.